In this video, you will learn how to create or insert these secondary axes in Excel graphs. You can see here I have inserted this secondary axis in bar graphs in this figure, and in second figure I have inserted secondary axis in line graph. You can look at this data. First column represents the months, second column the sales, and third column shows the profit. You can see here when we use these secondary axes, and then there is a larger difference between these two values. So when you have two columns which are significantly differ in values, then you can use these secondary axes. Because when you present these two columns on same axis, then this will be appear very smaller. For example, if I insert this graph using this data, so firstly select this data and insert cluster column chart. You can see here that this values hardly visible. So in these cases we use secondary axes. So let's start learning how to create these secondary axes. It's quite easy to insert secondary axes in line graph, but it is quite difficult to insert secondary axes in bar or column graph, because there is no magical button which we can use to insert these secondary axes in bar graphs. So for this purpose we use some tricks, and I will explain in later part of this video. Firstly, we will insert the secondary axis in line graph. The data is already inserted here. Select this data. Before this, I increase this size so it is more visible to you. And select this data. Go to insert, and we insert combo chart with secondary axis. From here we will use axis titles. So here this graph is sales versus profit. Click insert, and you can also format it. Similarly, this axis shows sales. And this shows profit. I will not format the whole figure because I have already uploaded video on combo chart. You can watch those video for if you are interested in the conditional formatting of this graph. In this graph I will only focus on the how to insert these secondary axes. So first we have inserted this line, and now we will convert this bar graph into line. Select this, right click, and go to change series chart type. From here you will select this cell. You can see here chart type is a cluster column. Now change chart type to line. You have option either you want lines with marker or without marker. You can see first line is without marker, so I will select this one without marker. Click on OK. Now you can see here that I have included two lines in these graphs which are displayed on two different axes. So that's we have completed this part of this video. So in next part we will learn how to create these secondary axes in bar graph. In bar graph this method is not working. You can see here, for example, if I go to insert and click on this, select this second axis, right click and format data series. You can see here, if I select this in secondary axis, these bars will be overlapped. And if I use these options of series overlap or gap widths, these are not working here. Similarly, combo chart is also not working here, because if I go to insert and here I will select combo chart with secondary axis, and I want to change this chart type, go to change series chart type and select line to clustered column. You can see here same problem exists here. So let's learn how we can get rid of this problem. For that purpose, you need two extra column. Select this column, right click and insert. Again select this column, right click and insert. So we have created two extra columns here. This column is sales blank. I will only write B, and it is profit blank. Now I will select this, go to insert tab and insert clustered column. Now this line represent secondary axis. Right click, go to format data series and select secondary axis for this. Now select here this column. You can see it is not visible. You can write any value in it. I write 1000. So here it is visible. Select this. This column, and here select secondary axis. Now you can see here these are plotted correctly, but its value is visible here. So we again format this. It was blank cell. So you have completed this graph, but you can see here the gap exists between these, and you can also adjust their width. For example, you select this, and in series option you will change series overlap to 0. And gap width to 100. Similarly, select this one. Change series overlap to 0. And gap widths to 100. Now you can see here the legend need formatting, because it shows four different things. Before this, you can use here, select this one, go to plus sign and insert axis title. I will just read here, write here sale, and this axis is a profit. If you want to learn about how to change the minimum or maximum value or the gap, or how to insert solid lines and how to change their color, as I shows in these graphs, you can watch the complete videos in my channels, and If you want to format this graph, you can watch the video on multiple bar graphs. Here I in detail explain the conditional formatting of these graphs. So let's learn how to format this legend. Click on this legend, then again click on this cell B and click on backscape. It will be deleted. Now again click the legend, and after that again click on profit B, click on backscape, and it is deleted. So you can see here I have completed this graph, and it has two axes. First axis shows sale and second profit. So if you like this video, then click on like button and subscribe my channel. Thanks for watching this tutorial.